I do think that Nick Drake has become such a cool celebre. There's a danger of there becoming a Nick Drake backlash, I think. People say, come on, he wasn't that special. He bloody was, you know. For
trouble. I knew Nick was making a record, but I had no idea what stage it had got to. And I remember him coming into my bedroom one morning, loping in as he did, 6'2" of him or whatever it was, and with that particular sort of shy smile on his face and sort of saying, here you are. And he threw this record down on my bed and it was Five Leaves Left. Fame is but a fruit tree, so very unsound. Nick's records didn't sell at all and he was desolate about that. I mean, he was absolutely desolate. And he didn't like performing live, so it was difficult. I mean, I saw him live, I thought he was good live, but he kept putting his head down, so the microphone was there, and so he never sang into the microphone, because he didn't like to look at the audience. Gonna see the river man. Last time I saw him was about 3 or 4 weeks, I think, before he died. I saw him in Holland Park, and he looked like Howard Hughes. He was all hunched over, and absolutely filthy, I mean just filthy, with huge long fingernails. And I stopped in the street to talk to him, but we didn't talk. He obviously was past talking. About the way his river flows. I think my parents wanted to think that it was an accident, really, but I've always found comfort in feeling that it was something he meant somewhere. And I felt that somewhere his work had come to a conclusion.